Hey guys, it's me Rahul and I'm back with another Android tips video. So today I will show you guys an easy method to control your PC using your Android phone and how to overclock your phone's CPU. Okay, without wasting further more time, let's do this. There are a lot of remote desktop applications, but the one that I recommend is Chrome Remote Desktop. It is pretty easy to set up and it is safe and secure. You need Chrome and Remote Desktop Chrome app to get started. You can find links to download all of the apps and the softwares in the description down below, so check it out. Open Chrome, then sign in with your Google account, then open the Remote Desktop Chrome app, then download the desktop app or the desktop client, and also download the app for your Android device. Then open the app on your Android device, then sign in with the same Google account. Then click on Enable Remote Connections on the Chrome app. Then enter a PIN with at least 6 digits, then click OK. Then open the Android app and tap on your PC name, then type in that PIN code. If you are planning to use this app for remote desktoping regularly, then you can tick this box to make things a bit more easier next time. If you tick it, the app won't ask for the PIN next time when you try to access. And that's it. Now you can control your PC using your Android device. It is pretty cool and I use it pretty much every time to check the render progress. So we are moving to the next topic, which is how to overclock your phone's CPU. So for those who don't know what CPU overclocking is, it basically means increasing the processing speed of a CPU. It is not the correct explanation, but I hope you understand. There are a bunch of apps available on the Play Store that will allow you to set a higher clock rate very easily. On this video, I will show you guys how to overclock using ZCPU and Kernel Editor. Both are really good applications. Before I get started, I just want to say a few things. Overclocking your CPU requires root access and a overclocking supported kernel, and doing it can damage your phone. It can result in boot loops and things like that, so be careful with this. And overclocking your CPU can make your device technically more quicker and faster, but in return your device will consume more battery power than usual and it will result in lesser battery life. So enough of me talking, let's just jump right into the main part. First app we are going to use is called Kernel Editor. Open the app, then select CPU from the side menu, then change the CPU maximum frequency, set to the highest value if you want to get more performance out of your phone's CPU, and set the minimum frequency a little bit higher than the lowest frequency. Don't set it too higher because that might negatively affect the performance. Then enable the apply on boot toggle and then reboot. Next app we are going to use to overclock CPU is called ZCPU. It is more easier and it has some more features that you can play with. Using this app you can set the CPU maximum and minimum frequency, then check on apply on boot and then reboot your device. This app has some cool features up at its sleeve like stress test, floating point bench, integer bench, native bench, etc. It is really a simple app to use, but it is not free right now. I think it was free when this app first came out, but yeah, it is not free right now. But if you really want to overclock your CPU, then this app worth the price. So hope you guys enjoyed this quick video. I want to do more different type of videos than the app list type of videos, so I will be experimenting some new ideas in the coming months. So hope you guys like this video. If you did, then definitely give a big thumbs up and I'll see you guys again in my next video. Goodbye.
Swear it's been 700 degrees in here since you came in. I could swear that this room has been running out of air, and now it's starting to spin.